Thursday night, everybody. Yeah. Welcome to another IGTV Live with yours truly. I'm Coach Sam Led out of beautiful Santa Barbara, California. I'm rocking one of the greatest albums of the 1970s, and he's coming to the Forum in LA, Elton John. If you haven't gotten this album, you need to check it out. Hey, Jeannie, welcome. I am Coach Sam Led on this cloudy and kind of creepily romantic rainy Thursday evening. And tonight we're going to talk about ghosting. Oh yeah. Okay, I'm going to turn this around. This song is so good though. Hey everybody. This song is so good. I can listen to this song all day actually. And the great thing is Elton John's coming for the last time in his career next month. I've been wanting to... I need to turn this down, but hold that thought, people. Okay. Again, welcome to another IGTV Live with yours truly, Coach Sam Led. I'm here at your pleasure. I'm here for you. You and you in the nosebleed seats. This is something that I love doing for y'all that are going through some major life transitions. Hey, Lynn, Sis, Nor Fitness. Wait, how do I... There we go. Welcome. Again, my name is Coach Sam Led. I am a trauma coach and life strategist in Santa Barbara, California. On this rainy night, and I'm here for you, you and you in the nosebleed seats. It is an honor and a privilege to be here for all of you. And tonight we're going to talk about ghosting. And it's so funny because, like, when I was in college, we didn't really have ghosting because we didn't have social media. And y'all millennials and Generation XYZ, whatever you call it, you know, I think you kind of brought it back because, you know, ghosting is something that is... It's not a comfortable thing to experience, and I'm going to share my own personal story. A lot of my clients, hey AJ, welcome. Hey Trina, welcome. A lot of my clients that are going through major life transitions, especially with heartbreak and relationships that are not going well for them, they've had a kind of a bad season. They didn't do well in the relations department for a year, and it was a good learning experience for them, but it was painful. And in the 21st century world with the advent of social media, we have ghosting. And it's so stupid, but the reality is that it exists and people engage in that activity. And those of you that have recently dealt with an experience of someone ghosted you or just disappeared off your radar, I know it's painful. And I'm going to share my own personal experience, and I think it might... shed some light because, you know, as a coach, as someone who works with people that are really looking in themselves to make some real changes, whether it's in their career or in the choices that they've made in the past that haven't worked for them, or their recovery from drugs and alcohol, or they're, you know, dealing with a major loss, all these pieces of our life really are there to teach us. You can call it spirit, you can call it the universe, that kind of weaves this very intricate tapestry of life lessons. And if you've learned the life lessons, you'll never let someone ghost you again, at least not on purpose. You'll never ever get into a relationship or the beginning of a relationship with someone that ghosts you. Because at the end of the day, and it's difficult to say this, it's your fault. I said it here, you're live in Santa Barbara. It's your fault if someone ghosts you. And that's hard to hear because the ego's yelling at me right now. Your ego's yelling at me and telling me to shut up, right? But it's the truth. We let certain people in our life that are not healthy for us because whether it's self-esteem, whether it's, you know, we are learning how to speak our voice and let ourselves be heard in the world. Whether we have past trauma that's preventing us from speaking up when it's appropriate. In the age of social media, in the age of online dating, ghosting really tests those of us that are really learning these really painful lessons from the past. And they're the best teachers. Unfortunately, they are very painful teachers, especially if you love someone that just ghosts you out of nowhere. I'm going to turn this down so you all can hear me. I'm going to tell you a little story. It's not a little story. It's actually a big story, but it's little now because it's, I learned a very big lesson from it in my own life, being a man on this planet and being in relationships with women and learning about what works for me, what doesn't work for me. I was married for 4.5 years, and my ex-wife ghosted me. And I saw the red flags way from the beginning of the relationship. But part of me didn't want to see it because I was crafting a reality that I thought was the reality of our relationship, of our marriage. But that was my perception. I was having difficulty coming to terms with what really the relationship was, the health of the relationship was, and who the other person was, my ex-wife. She disappeared. She went back to her home country. She just left. And I had two emails from her. And then I decided to file for divorce. And it was the most painful experience of my life, next to watching someone die or losing a loved one. But it was the most powerful teacher, because I did see the red flags. And I did see the, all the kind of evidence of her behavior, which was not healthy, which was not healthy for her, which was not healthy for us in our relationship. And at the end of the day, it was toxic. And when someone ghosts you, it doesn't matter if they're straight out of college and they're immature, you can't blame it on immaturity. This is their character speaking to you, loud and clear, okay? And we create these kind of mental schemas, these mental maps of how we think others are, right? We create this kind of like Camelot fairy tale of this beautiful person we met that we think is the most amazing thing since sliced bread. And we create these cognitive kind of tapestries about who we think they are when they really are not what we think they are. Yeah, that makes sense. So what ended up happening is that I learned a terribly painful lesson. And lost my wife, but it had to happen. It had to happen. And the red flags were there. And a lot of times when we're swept up in these neurochemicals of lust, of love, and that wasn't really love, if someone ghosts you, that's not really love, that's just lust. That's our own neurochemicals, our own dopamine taking hostage of our brain, our cognitive and rational brain, and that can happen. But I want you to really take a step back and look at your relationships, and I want you to write down, if you have a piece of paper handy, I want you to kind of write down how many times you've been ghosted in the last year, okay? That's one. Two, why do you think you attracted these kind of people into your life? Because it doesn't matter if these people are immature or they just weren't ready for a relationship or they were scared. There's no excuse for it. You know, the way I approach this is that these people, their emotional intelligence was really not developed. Because people that have a really good sense of self of who they are grounded, and love themselves, don't ghost other people. Hear that a second. People that have emotional intelligence, right? They might not be the smartest, they might not be the most attractive, but if they really have emotional intelligence and have a good sense of who they are as a person and are emotionally sound or whatever that is and are grounded in themselves, do not do that to other people. It doesn't matter what the reason is, okay? The kind of people that ghost arbitrarily other people are the ones that have a ill-defined sense of identity. The ones that have very low emotional intelligence, that don't really understand who they are, that don't really have a real solid emotional container, don't know how to deal with conflict, don't know how to say no, don't know how to say, you know what, I don't think this is going to work out, you know, thank you for the experience, thank you for spending time with me, just it's not going to work out. Hey Chris, thank you for joining. Awesome. I see some old faces, actually, which is very cool. But we are ultimately responsible for the people that we attract into our life. Hey, Dave, welcome. We are ultimately responsible for the people that we attract into our life. So if you're constantly being ghosted by people, that's your fault. And that's hard to hear, right? It's your fault. So go back and take an inventory of all the relationships, all the people that have ghosted you or just disappeared in the last couple years of your life. And write down a little notes about, okay, what were the red flags? Because usually someone that does the ghosting, there are subtle red flags. And every relationship is unique. You know, one of the red flags is that they're too good to be true. They ingratiate you with love bombing or these, you know, they just met you and they're you know, being too nice. They're being over the top affectionate. It might be the first date and they're already saying that you're the one and you're like the best thing since apple pie. Okay, you have to question that. These are the kind of people that do ghost because their feel of reality, their sense of self is so disconnected from how they really feel. A lot of people that ghost just don't know how to deal with saying no. They don't know how to deal with being their own self-advocate. They don't know how to deal with asserting themselves for whatever reason. You know, we all have things in our life, in our relationships that we need to work on, whether it's our emotional health, whether it's our financial health. You know, none of us are perfect. These aren't bad people. They're not emotionally sound people. People that ghost others arbitrarily. Even if you're a man and you're out in the town, you know, and you're just sowing your wild oats, even the ones that do that, and we all of us, you know, have been there. I mean, I went to college. I lived in South Florida. I survived it when I was in my 20s. Being a good human being and being an emotionally sound person, if you ghost somebody, that is saying a lot about your emotional integrity and who you are as a person. Because even if it was just a fling, even if, you know, there was no real future in the relationship, being honest and direct and telling people how you feel instead of ghosting them, you know, instead of just throwing them out like they're some kind of recycled pair of jeans, you know, you don't need anymore, says a lot about your character. And I learned a lot about that with through my ex-wife. It was the most painful and the most uncomfortable experience. To someone that I thought loved me. Hey, Garello, welcome. I see some familiar faces. Someone who I thought loved me, someone who I thought saw me as I saw them, disappear. Poof. Okay? And it's my fault because I let it happen. And there were all the red flags there. Someone who is not does not have that emotional intelligence or the capacity to understand the true dance that goes on in whether it's a hookup or a relationship or a fling, and being a human being of ethics and morals and being empathic for the other person, saying, you know what, it didn't work out, we had fun, it's not going to work for me, and then you move on. And that's really the sad. You know, it's a sad case for a lot of people out there that are looking to build partnerships and real relationships. Real relationships take time. They take effort. They take patience. They take a sense of humor. Okay? They take intuition. You know, part of building your coping muscle and building your intuition and creating a real coping muscle for yourself and also tapping into your intuition and clearing out the cobwebs and being able to really understand other human beings as creatures that are perfectly imperfect is understanding and using your intuition, understanding that people are not going to show up always how you see them. And using your intuition is a powerful thing to kind of weed out the people that ghost and act immaturely. Hey, Kathy, welcome. You know, some relations are transitory, right? List your relationships right now on a piece of paper that were transitory, but didn't end up in ghosting, you know? You know, if you're in a big city like New York or San Francisco, you know, ghosting happens a lot, big cities, right? If they ghost you, consider it a blessing because these people were not meant to be in your life. You were there to learn something from them. And if they do ghost you, it's your fault. Because you know, your screening process for weeding out the schmucks that come into your life is not working. Hear that again. Your screening process for weeding out the schmucks, so the people that are not healthy for you, even if it's a first date, even if maybe they're attractive, you think they're really cute, right? Your screening process, your system to which you screen out the morons and the people that do ghost others is not working. Write down a piece of paper. Why is that process, why is that system not working for me? What are my insecurities? What are the insecurities and self-esteem issues that I have that are the reason why I'm attracting people that ghost me? You know, these are hard questions, but you know, I look at ghosting like other areas of our life, you know? If you're constantly having relationship failures and people are constantly ghosting you and relationships are just, you know, transitory and they're not, nothing sticks, ask yourself how well your screening system is of weeding out the people that are not right for you. You know, we all need intimacy. We all crave connection. We all crave sex sometimes. We all need that connection. But there's a healthy connection that builds over time, and then there's unhealthy connections that, yeah, one night stand or anything like that. But if they ghost you, if they didn't have the dignity to at least call you and say, I had a great time, I don't think we're the right fit, you know, good luck, or you go on a couple dates with them and you're in a quasi, kind of you're seeing each other, quote unquote, and then they just disappear. You have to ask yourself the question, what did I notice in the dance between us that wasn't working? Or what were the red flags that came up that I just ignored because I really, my version, my perception of this beautiful person on the other table was not in alignment of how they felt about me, or was not in alignment to who they really were. You know, we create these kind of cognitive schemas about what we think about our partners or people that are important to us in our life. And the ones that stick, the ones that are meant to be in your life, develop over time. Take their time. And you might go up, you know, you might have some hurdles. You might, you know, have arguments. You might have difficulties. The ones that stand the test of time are the right people for you. The ones that ghost you, if you're constantly being ghosted by somebody, you're attracting them because the universe is trying to tell you that you don't feel too good about yourself. You don't really love yourself that much because you keep attracting these men or women that don't respect you or your time. Because remember, when you go on a date with somebody, right, you're putting your time and your money and your energy into this to see, you know, maybe it'll work out. Maybe there's a future in it. But if the red flags are there and you're feeling uneasy and something's off and something doesn't feel right and you're continuing to do the dance with this person and then they just disappear and ghost you, well, there you go. You know, it's hindsight's 20/20, and we're all human beings on this, you know, rotating rock we call planet Earth to find some of the answers to our own, you know, the puzzle of our own life, whether it's in our career, whether it's in our family relationships, whether it's romance and dating in the 21st century. My other piece of advice to you is that, you know, the way to eliminate or minimize, I'd say, the potential for ghosting is fucking get rid of your dating apps and do it the organic way, you know? Join a meetup group, activities that you love to do. Of course, there could be some schmucks and scumbags in those groups, you know, because we all have the potential to be an asshole, right? We all have the potential to not be good people, you know? We haven't learned the lessons and we haven't evolved and we haven't done the work, you know? Scuttle the whole 21st century dating app nonsense and go, if you love bowling, join a bowling league. If you love tennis, join tennis league in your age group. If you love, I don't know, underwater basket weaving, go to the local city college and take an underwater basket weaving course. Engage in activities that get you out of your head and immerse you in areas that you love, and hobbies and areas of area, I can't speak, and hobbies and areas of life that you love doing, and meet people that hey Joshua, welcome, that you really connect with and resonate with, and the odds of you meeting someone who's going to totally ghost you are very, you know, are much are minimized compared to going out, you know, and downloading Tinder or Bumble, Fumble, whatever the hell it's called. But you know, there are some dating apps that are great. I met my lovely, I met my partner on Inner Sanctum, Inner Circle. Sorry, right, Jeannie? But we approached it very differently. You know, we did it the old-fashioned way. We took our time. We saw our past failures. I shared the story of my ex-wife and how fucked up that was. And how I got ghosted by my wife who disappeared and left the country. And it's my fault because I let it happen, because I saw the red flags. And those of you just joining me for the first time, we're talking about ghosting. And we're talking about the workaround, how to not get involved with someone who ghosts you. Because it's not okay. It shouldn't be okay for you. It's not acceptable behavior. If you want to be an adult, I don't care if you're 20 or 18 or 50. If you want to be a mensch, a good person, if you want to be a good human being with morals, and that because you love people and you care about people, maybe not like love the person across from you at the table eating dinner that you're going on a date with, but do the right thing and say, you know what, it's not going to work out. Call them the next day and say thank you for the meeting. And hello, Carmelicious. Nice, Carmelicious. Do the right thing and call them up the next day and say, you know what, it's just not going to work out. I just don't think we're the right fit. And you know, it takes, what, a minute instead of, what, disappearing and ghosting? You think that's cool? Not cool. Your life is not that busy. I don't care if you're an ER doctor and you're working, you know, a 12-hour shift. You have time to pick the phone up and call that person you went on a date with that you don't think it's going to work out. And being honest. Being honest. And those of you that can, again, are continually attracting people that are ghosting you, you need to take a reality check and take an inventory of your own self-esteem and your own sense of self and your own sense of self-love and saying, why is this continuing happening to me? Well, it's my fault. I need to take responsibility. It's not their fault. They're assholes on their own, separate from you. You're not an asshole. You're a good person worthy of a loving and caring and loyal partner, okay? You know, if you're right out of college and you want to sell your wild oats, fine. But send messages to them saying, you know what, I'm not ready for a relationship, instead of just ghosting them. It takes a lot more to be immature and to be a child and ghost somebody. And you're hurting that other person, even if it was just a fling or a hookup or a one-night stand, than it is to fucking pick the phone up, dial the 7 digits like we used to do in, like, you know, us Gen Xers, what we used to do, you know, pick up the phone and make a phone call and actually talk to someone live and say, hi, Sally, I had a great time with you the other night. You know what? I just don't think it's going to fucking work out. Don't say fucking. I just don't think this is going to work out. You're an amazing person. Good luck to you. Ba-boom. That's it. I mean, that's what? 15 seconds phone call? How hard is that? Not that difficult. Now imagine, and again, I'm saving y'all a life of misery, because when my ex-wife took off and went back to Europe after being together almost 5 years, you know, I'm going through this whole inventory. Okay, what did I do wrong? How much of an asshole was I? You know, this whole inventory, you know, beating myself up, thinking about, I'm dissecting the last 1,400 days of our relationship and saying, oh my God, what is it that I did that, you know, why couldn't she just say, you know what, it's not going to work out. You know, I think we should get a divorce. It'd be painful. It's hurtful. And it's my fault because I let it happen and I attracted someone like that. And you know what had happened as a result? Was the best thing that ever happened. Because when you're in a toxic relationship or a relationship that you should not be in or a marriage you should not be in, even though if the person's gorgeous and they're, you know, worldly and they speak 10 languages and they have a master's degree from some cockamamie university in Switzerland and, you know, tripling the life fantastic and, you know, blah, 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 blah. That has nothing to do with their character. You know, character goes a long way in life. Your character is, you know, the footprint that you leave when you're gone, when you die, okay? And this is a cliche, and y'all heard this before. You know, people are not going to remember you by the type of car you drive or how wealthy you were. They're going to remember you by how much you impacted their life. Now, ghosting and let's be honest, you know, it's not the end of the world if someone ghosts you. But, you know, your time is precious. Spend time with people who deserve to be in your sphere, deserve to be in your presence. Love yourself enough to see that just because the other person you're sexually attracted to and there's some dopamine and neurochemicals floating around and you want to be with them intimately, look at the long term. Look at the long term. If you're seeing red flags on the first date or early on, no matter how painful it is to be alone sometimes, no matter how painful it is to not have a partner, the worst thing you can do to yourself is be with someone who doesn't deserve to be in your life, who's just a transitory, hey, mindful, is that Mindful Mermaid? Awesome. Who's a transitory person in your life. You don't need a transitory person in your life. You don't. Because, you know, like attracts like. Because if you're continuing to have these people come into your life that are ghosting you, that are not treating you with respect, who are not really seeing you as the wonderful person that you are. Hey, Ricardo Ski, welcome. Imagine if you turn the tables around, right? They're a mirror because they don't respect you and they're going to ghost you because you don't respect you, right? They're treating you like crap because you're treating yourself like crap. How about them apples? And that's hard to hear. I realized after, you know, and getting back to my own past marriage disaster, it wasn't all disaster. We had good times, but when someone ghosts you, when you've been in a relationship with them for almost 5 years, married to them for 5 years, they're ultimately the mirror in your life. And it's painful to look at yourself through this other person who's treating you like shit. You see the red flags because that's ultimately subconsciously how you feel about yourself. And that's hard to hear. It's kind of, and it translated overflows into your professional relationships, into your career too. Say that you've had, you know, a couple of pretty awful jobs or, you know, companies that you've been working for have been awful and you've been either laid off or you've been fired or it just didn't work out. And you're struggling to stay employed because you keep getting involved in companies that are not the right fit for you. Look, the realities of life are we all have to eat. We will have to pay the bills. We all have to pay our rent or your mortgage. You know, we might even have kids to feed. But if you do it the right way when it comes to the relationships in your life and you take your time and you don't try to quicken the process. And you don't try to, like, you know, I think speed dating was the worst thing that ever happened to my generation. Remember speed dating? You'd go to like a bar and then like you'd go from one person to the next. That's, you know, real connection, real relationships take time. They take effort. They take sense of humor. They take a passionate commitment to love someone despite who they are, despite their imperfections. And if you're attracting people that are constantly ghosting you, and I have colleagues, I have clients that get been ghosted. I had a client that was ghosted for the entire 2018. It's one of the other reasons why I'm talking about this today, because it's such a popular topic. You have to really take inventory of why this is happening to you. Because I guarantee you, if you're having this experience of chronic ghosting, it's probably spilling over into your professional relationships too. Because you're not loving yourself enough, and your intuition, you're not listening to your inner voice when it's screaming at you to stop, to not get involved with this person, even if, and maybe it's because they're wealthy or they look good or they wear, you know, fancy suit or they are just like just cool. And they know everybody and they're popular and they have all the money and blah, 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 blah. That's great for them. Bless them. As hard as that is, you know what, if you're not in that place right now and you're, you know, you're struggling financially or otherwise, it's hard to say no to people that are so alluring and so beautiful, but turn out to ghost you within a day or two. And then you're back at square one again, licking your wounds, saying, what the hell happened? What the hell happened was is that you didn't have enough respect for yourself and self-love for yourself to say no to a person that was not right for you. Okay, I hope this has been helpful. It's my pleasure to share my own personal experience. I don't like to do that a lot, but I think it's powerful. Ultimately, you know, you have agency over the people that you allow into your life. And I know that's hard, especially if, you know, you're feeling alone and you're feeling like there's nobody there for you. There's a great Grateful Dead song, you know. They tell me this town ain't got no heart. You just got to look around. The same thing goes for relationships. Same thing goes for people. If you suffered a loss or you're dealing with something really heavy right now, the last thing you want to do is to distract yourself from the work you need to do by getting into a relationship or you know, a fling with someone who's going to ultimately ghost you. So, you know, I want you to take away from this three things. When you are connecting with people, if you're single or you're newly single and you're going out and you're dating and you're back into the dating world again, look at it as a pseudo research experiment, right? An anecdotal experiment. You know, take notes. You know, you're interviewing them on a date as much as they're interviewing you, right? Check, you know, really tune into your intuition. What's resonating with you? The way they're talking to you, the way they're looking at you, how they smell. Really pay attention to all these different neurochemical signals. If something doesn't feel right, regardless of how wealthy they are, or how good looking they are, or how blah, blah, blah they are, thank them for the date and walk away. Try it. And then after that date, take an inventory. You know, what was it like to, you know, to really listen to what I need, what my needs were, and finding a partner that is deserving of my attention and of my love and of my body. And the odds are, if you really listen to yourself, regardless how desperate you are, regardless how poor you are, regardless of where you are, if you're living in a Shacktown shack or in Beverly Hills or wherever, if you really have discernment and listen to your inner voice when you're meeting people or you're looking, you know, you're on a date with somebody, a new person, the odds of them ghosting you or you falling into that ghosting trap will be very diminished. And stand up for yourself. If, you know, even if you're feeling lonely, even if you want human connection, even if you're horny, you know, there are other ways to deal with all that stuff in the temporary. You know what I'm talking about? Temporarily, until you come across the right partner that you connect with, that you love them because of who they are. And the biggest gift after myself, after really learning and painfully learning about what it's like to be ghosted on a big spectrum, my ex-wife, you know, ghosting me and taking off. You know, I'm an adult. We were adulting. We had a life. We had a house. We had friends. We had family. The biggest gift and the biggest gift out of that whole nightmare was finding someone that I met over 7 months ago that was the gift out of all this. That I finally learned the lesson myself to listen to my inner voice, to listen to what I needed in a relationship in another person. It takes time. It's painful sometimes. You're going to fall down and, you know, you're going to get back up and you're going to dust yourself off. But ultimately, if you listen to this, your heart, your inner voice, and your intuition, when you're in the, you know, you're in the dating scene, the odds of being ghosted will be minimized. Again, there's exception to every rule. Sometimes it just happens, but there's no excuse for it. If you're being ghosted, it's your fault. And I'm going to leave it at that. We're going to end with that. If you're interested in the work that I do, check out my website. Go to www.solutionist180.com. If you want to send me an email, or just click the contact me on the homepage. My services are available. I usually book clients out a month or two in advance. And we're going to do this next Thursday, 6:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, IGTV Live. We're going to take another deep dive. And it was a pleasure and an honor to speak with all of you. I hope this has been of help. Hope you've enjoyed this. Don't give up. And don't let people that ghost you into your life, ever. Take it easy, everybody. Check it out. I'm going to end with little Alton John, who's coming to the forum. When is it? In February. Last time. If you like Alton John, I do. You should too. Just kidding. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Great album. Good night, everybody. Have a great weekend. And don't give up. Oh, yeah. Good night, everybody.